When Einstein published his theory of special relativity, it caused a great commotion in the scientific community. The reason for this was that special relativity implied a number of counterintuitive changes that an object goes through when it is moving. These consequences of special relativity contradict Newtonian mechanics, but they have, as of 2014, agreed with all the experimental evidence. But the consequences are generally observable only for objects moving near the speed of light, and so, for low speeds, Newtonian mechanics is still used in calculations. One consequence is time dilation. Time dilation is a result of the lack of an absolute time, says that for any object in motion, time passes slower. The relation between the rate of time at rest and at motion is related by the Lorentz factor, a factor that for an object's speed, v, is equal to 1 over the square root of 1 minus v squared over c squared. One can see that for low values of v, the Lorentz factor is almost 1, so the time does not actually change too much, but at the speed of light, time freezes. Time dilation is also the subject of the twin paradox, a thought experiment that is not actually a paradox. In the twin paradox, a pair of twins is separated. One is sent in a spaceship moving near the speed of light. The other twin stays on Earth. After a certain amount of time, if the first twin returns to the Earth, he would have aged less than the other twin, just by virtue of being in motion. While this originally seemed like a paradox, it is truly not a paradox if one keeps in mind that time is relative. Now, while special relativity predicts time dilation, there are even more absurd consequences. One of these is the concept of length contraction. This says that an object in motion appears to look shorter, but it is, in fact, the same size. This becomes even more strange when you realize that the length contracts only in the direction of the motion. So, a box moving in one direction will seem to get flattened as only one dimension gets shorter. The length of a moving object also decreases by the Lorentz factor. Once again, at the speed of light, the moving object seems to have a length of zero. Interestingly enough, length isn't the only aspect of an object that changes. When an object is moving, its mass increases, again, by the Lorentz factor. This comes from the energy of motion turning into mass, which can be calculated by the formula E equals mc squared. This leads to yet another interesting result. For an object with mass, moving at the speed of light is impossible. This is because its mass becomes infinite, but for mass to become infinite, an infinite amount of energy is required. Now, there is only a finite amount of energy, and the law of conservation of energy says that energy cannot be created, but it can only be transformed from one form to another. This means that no object can move at speeds greater than the speed of light. No matter what particle is moving, the speed of light is the cosmic speed limit. So far, no particles have been observed to exceed the speed of light, but if anything ever moves faster than the speed of light, the laws of time dilation and length contraction will just completely break down, and physicists will be left scratching their heads. But for now, Einstein is right, so we will have to accept the fact that we can never travel faster than the speed of light.